We're now rolling with Kelton Swartz, the strategist from Cerner, talking about QAPI for you and QAPI for me.
Thank you. Sounds like a song, doesn't it? Well, I'm actually here to actually get you kind of pumped up for QAPI. It's here. It's not going away. I think something we want to take away from today's session is, you know, how to make it fun for you, if we can make something like this fun in the industry. So I think if we go back to the beginning, I wasn't around at this point in time, as you can probably tell. But this is what I think quality was in long-term care and in nursing in a nutshell. But we were caregivers first and foremost, and we were there for the residents and the patients back at that point in time. We probably didn't have a lot of regulations, but if you think about QA today, quality assurance, we're really kind of defined by those rules, regulations, and this checklist that we unfortunately come across with CMS and other governing bodies, and that's really kind of how we view quality assurance in many aspects, and so do our stakeholders in today's session. Unfortunately, when it comes to quality assurance, we also become more looking at the trends of putting band-aids over the problems we see in quality assurance. And that's unfortunate because there's a lot of things going to QA. We spend a lot of our time focusing on that band-aid effect. With performance improvement being added to the quality assurance program, we're looking at the performance across multiple teams. As you can see, we're looking at more than one disciplined facility, but also setting targets and goals for the performance of that facility. And that's the key takeaway with this new initiative. So for quality assurance, looking at just you as a quality assurance coordinator, you're still looking at the rules, regulations, and you're always trying to play catch up with what's being forced at you based upon those checklists you have to look at within your QA process. And then looking at QAPI today, it really expands that role from just one QA coordinator to the entire team. You can see there's multiple roles in the facility, the executive team, but also looking at the data sources in your facility, not just EHR data, but also resident interviews and families. Who all here likes paprika in their food, by the way? Anyone use paprika at home?
I do.
I figured you might. I think paprika is the secret ingredient to quality assurance and performance improvement. The PIP, Performance Improvement Projects, and Root Cause Analysis is really the key differentiator we need to look at going forward. So, under quality assurance, we're more reactionary. I don't know, many people that I've met in facilities do this on a weekly basis, especially when surveys coming due or the window opens up or there's a QA issue. We want to get away from that with QAPI and actually make it more of an interdisciplinary role that involves more people than we've had before, not just the DON, the QA coordinator, but let's involve the dietary manager, the cook, the chef, let's involve maintenance. All these different roles play a key role at looking at the proactive aspect of QAPI. So the PIP team is really the key ingredient to paprika. That is the core base of having different disciplines working together, looking at what care areas you want to tackle, assess, and improve on, not based upon just a quality measure. While quality measures are great, and MBS data is great, you can look at this example for unexplained weight loss as a possible PIP project in the facility. There are other aspects you can look at rather than just quality measures, but start looking at your trends. You've got the data today, might as well start. One thing you want to make sure, though, is just be smart about your goals. Look at them making specific, measurable, actionable, realistic, and time-bound. That's unfortunately one of the things that was taken away from the pilot study that did not work out well for SNFs, but this is a key ingredient for your success with QAPI. Also looking at root cause analysis, again, use more than just your MDS data. You have access to a plethora of amounts of data in your facility, your point of care, the residents. This example of weight loss, you can look at your traditional assessments. Dig into your data. The other takeaway is the 5Y component. Remember, as a kid, I always asked my mom, why? I still do today, actually. But that's really the baseline we want to look at in your facility, is ask those 5Ys of why these things are occurring, and you'll get to the answer so that when you get to the next step component of your executive council, say, do we want to implement change in this facility based on what we found, or are we going to hold back and not do this yet today? We're not quite ready. That's something you want to be very cautious about, but also a great opportunity for you to make a big change very easily. I would encourage you to make sure that as you're looking through your quality assurance and performance improvement projects, make sure you're continuously analyzing your data and making sure you are making a systematic change in the facility. I think that's a shortcoming that we all forget about sometimes. So the magic question is, where's the deadline? When we start doing QAPI? We've all heard that there's no regulations out yet. Start today. We passed that deadline last fall. There's no reason why you can't start today. You've got the data, you've got the ability, you've got the critical thinking skill sets in your power to do that. Why is this also important? What's yet to come? Well, we all know that we have pay for performance. We know that we're going to get paid in the future based on the quality of care we deliver. So we might as well start thinking in that mindset today and be ahead of the curve when those regulations do come and change. So let's get started today. QAPI is for you, but it's also for me as a stakeholder. We all can do it. We all have the power to do it. It's just a new way of thinking about quality assurance to make a bigger change that's not just regulatory based. So I appreciate your time today. Have a great day.